Very quickly, let's shift focus. And thanks very much, Himain Gaurang. Appreciate you joining in and, of course, helping out our viewers. But we do have WPI numbers flashing at the bottom of your screen. It's a 2.02% number versus the comparable figure of 2.45% that we had in the previous month. We were expecting a cool-off coming in, and this makes it the third consecutive lower print that we've had coming in on the wholesale price index number. So 2.02%, barely holding up above the 2% figure. This is, of course, divergent to the kind of trend that we're seeing on the consumer inflation side. CPI, it's an 8-month high that we got coming in for the same month of June, but June WPI inflation is now at 2%, just over 2%, 2.02%. We'll wait for some of the breakup, really get a sense of where we've seen this cooling off coming in, but Aditi Nayar, Principal Economist at ICRA, is joining in. Aditi, were you expecting a headline number so low? It's 2.02%.
Thank you. You know, we were actually expecting the headline number to come in at around 2.1 to 2.2%. So it's a little bit lower than what we were expecting. And I think a large part of the decline from the May levels is coming in because of a base effect. And also the fact that core inflation is at really low levels right now. So I expect that that would have continued. On the other hand, we were expecting food inflation to firm up further from the already very high levels of around 7% in line with the kind of uptick that we saw in the CPI inflation. So I would expect that there has been some increase in food inflation, but the base effect and a very low core print have probably pulled down the headline number a little bit more than what we had expected. One of the interesting things that's really coming out now between the CPI and the WPI is that food inflation is possibly rising, but is lower than core in one index, which is the CPI, and significantly higher than the core in the other index, which is the WPI. And the wedge is very substantial as far as the WPI is concerned. So a little bit of, you know, interesting dynamics in terms of really looking at how the inflation at the different indices is going to shape up going forward.
Valid point, Aditi. A little more breakup that we have available with us. So it's a two-year low as far as the WPI goes. The April WPI, in fact, has been revised higher to 3.2%, but at 2.02% for the June WPI data, it is a two-year low that we are seeing right now. Manufacturing is at just about 1% versus 1.3 on a month-on-month basis. Fuel, power and lighting is in fact at negative 2.2 versus 1%. Primary articles has remained sticky at 6.7% versus 6.16 on a month-on-month basis. We are still to get the vegetable and the food. Okay, so vegetable also has moderated significantly, Aditi, coming in at 24, nearly 25%. Versus 33.15% on a month-on-month basis. So while we would be happy with, you know, inflation data like this, and even if CPI has risen to an 8-month high, the core inflation has fallen down, combined with a dip in industrial activity, just pointing to the fact that the slowdown is persistent, slowdown is real, and it's no longer urban or rural, it's across.
I do think so, and I think that this definitely reinforces our expectation that between the CPI numbers that we saw on Friday and the headline numbers that you just read out, that we should expect another rate cut coming in from the MPC, really to move to more of a growth supportive kind of a policy outlook. At least we would expect that in the next policy, if not then in the subsequent one. To some extent, transmission is incomplete. That's possibly the only reason that the MPC may wish to take a pause, but I think there's a higher likelihood that we're going to see a rate cut in the next policy. The other concern was the monsoon. We have had a definite catch-up in the last week or so. Sowing data is also significantly better than what it seemed about a week ago. So I think in terms of the outlook for food inflation, other than the seasonal factors that are going to push up vegetable prices, etc., during the rains, and maybe a little bit of a second-round impact coming in from higher fuel prices feeding into prices of perishables through the transport angle, we do think that overall, at least at the retail level, food inflation is going to remain relatively benign. It is going to go up from the levels that we've been seeing, but it's going to remain relatively benign. So I think that's a positive fact. And core, as far as the WPI is concerned, is at extremely low levels. If the overall manufacturing is at 1%, the core portion of that can't be any higher. So core being around 1.1% maybe at the wholesale level, and the dip that we saw in the CPI core inflation as well, I think do support the case for one more rate cut and then a pause to really reassess how the transmission has been and whether more rate cuts are needed to prop up economic growth.
All right, so definitely another rate cut, whether or not it comes immediately, fourth consecutive rate cut in August, it remains to be seen. But at any rate, these kind of numbers open up significant room along with the lower growth environment that we're looking at for the MPC to go ahead and cut rates. We just have a couple more of the components that have come in. Food inflation, it's 5.04% versus the 5.10% number that we had. And food articles inflation, 6.98%. So nearly the same as the number that we had last time, 6.99%. Non-food articles inflation at 5.06%. That has come off from an over 6% number that we had last time. Vegetables inflation has definitely moderated and the headline number is significantly lower with the kind of core inflation number that we had on the CPI front, Aditi. You know, it's just over 4%. And we know now that the MPC, the RBI governor from the minutes, have been focusing on that core inflation number rather than, you know, the overall headline number as far as CPI goes. What do you expect the trajectory will be like? Because you did point to some of the upside risks on the oil front. We also have a deficient monsoon. Do you expect that even while the RBI or the MPC is looking at an accommodative environment, there are still upside risks that they haven't quite flagged off?
See, I think the upside risks as such have moderated to some extent, particularly from the monsoon and the sowing front. So definitely in that case, we did think that the situation was a bit more alarming about a week or two ago, but we've seen quite a bit of a catch-up as far as the volume of rainfall is concerned, and sowing also, there is still a deficit as compared to last year, but at least now there is some amount of traction, about 40% of the overall area, in terms of the total from last year has been sown already. Couple of areas where we're still lagging is pulses and rice, where only 25% of the area has been sown yet, so we would hope to see a good catch up in another week or so. Overall, I would say that from the sowing side and the monsoon side, the risks are now slightly less than what they were, so that's a comfort factor. As far as vegetables are concerned, the daily data that we're seeing is showing that there is a big increase in prices of some vegetables. And here the transport cost angle in terms of the diesel price hike may play a little bit of a role in pushing up prices a little bit further. But I don't think that it's something which is going to be a major concern. As far as core is concerned, we've seen a dip in this month and we hope that will continue, that the trend will remain, in terms of a range-bound core inflation number on the CPI side. The other larger sort of global factor in terms of crude oil prices, we do expect them to remain range-bound because there are concerns over oversupply which are there. And as far as INR is concerned also, particularly with the budget announcement of sovereign external debt issuance in the second half of the year, I think here again we do expect that the INR may remain fairly steady in the next couple of months. So we're looking at an INR range of maybe 68 to 69.5 over the next few months. Crude should remain largely on average around the current levels. So some of the risks going forward would probably be contained. Now, in terms of the food inflation number in the WPI that you just read out, actually that's what's come in lower than what we were expecting. So from the risk of high wholesale food inflation going into retail prices, I think here again it's a slightly lower risk than what we were assessing earlier. And core WPI, which is really manufactured products, inflation levels are so low right now that I don't think those are a concern. Core CPI, which brings in more of the services, is above 4%, but it's really within striking distance of the overall medium-term target as well. So I think the risks are there, but they seem to be fairly balanced at this point in time, and I think that does support the case for one more rate cut before we take a pause and really reassess how the transmission has been.
Right, so definitely room for one more rate cut, needs better transmission going forward from here as well. Aditi, thanks so much for joining in and running us through reading of the inflation print. So there you have it, confirmation that inflation is cooling down. Even if you did have that minor uptick in CPI, core inflation was down. Wholesale prices are down even further than what the street was estimating, coming in at a two-year low of just a shade over 2%. Across all verticals, there has been a contraction as far as the inflation data goes, as far as the prices go, even if food prices in some areas have remained sticky. But that's the reading of the inflation numbers for you. It's all eyes next on the RBI policy next month and whether the MPC will choose to go for another rate cut or not. But thank you so much for watching this exclusive coverage of the WPI data.